Yesterday, I gave you a quick overview of what conversion rate optimization actually is and why it's important. If you haven't checked out that video, that I recommend you do it now. And today, I want to give you five simple but often overlooked hacks that will help you boost the conversion rate of pretty much any page that you can think of in your funnel. And the first hack is actually something that a lot of people absolutely don't think about, and it's market message matching between the previous part of your funnel and the current part of your funnel. Now, if you think, what the hell are you talking about, Csaba? Let me explain. Let's say you run a Facebook ad and people click through from that Facebook ad to your landing page. In this case, you want to make sure that the marketing message is consistent between the two. It creates a natural link between the call to action of your Facebook ad and the headline of your landing page, because this is the thing that people actually expect. If they click on, let's say, a 50% off buy now button on your Facebook ad, then they don't expect a sophisticated emotional hook or something on your landing page. They expect to be reassured that they've clicked to the right place and that they indeed are going to receive a big discount. And Facebook actually penalizes you for this. So if people land on your landing page and they bounce, too many of them bounce, then your ad costs are going to go up. Because in their logic, you know, if people land somewhere and they bounce, then it's not good quality enough. Then it's basically, it's kind of like a scam, or they didn't get what they were looking for. And it's a bad experience for them. And Facebook really doesn't want this. And the same is true for emails. If you end an email with the call to action that click here to learn more about your course, then don't give them a big discount immediately or something. Then make sure that the sales page that they link to is positioned in a way that they actually learn something new about your course. So this was the first tip. The second tip is to ensure that your user experience is top-notch quality. Because let's face it, we live in 2020. A lot of web pages are very good looking. They're nicely designed. They have good UX. So you basically cannot let yourself fall behind, because even if you just look like a web page from 2015, people will already think that you're outdated. So you want to make sure that you use templates, or your web developers use templates or wireframes that are very modern and they adhere to the current trends. But don't be afraid to be a little different. The important thing is to have a UX which is very easy to use. It's mobile optimized. This is super, super important. Yet some people still overlook this fact. About 70% of traffic comes from mobile. So you have to make sure that all your pages are mobile optimized. And also the colors, the elements, the spacing between them, white space and everything is nice and consistent. And it just looks good. It also adheres to your brand and what your brand tries to message, what it tries to communicate to your audience. And I won't really get into more detail into UX, because it deserves its own course and everything. But just know that you should definitely hire a UX designer or a UX professional in order to boost the effectiveness of your web page, because nowadays it's an essential thing, in my opinion. Okay, the third hack that I have for you is tied to the first week of this challenge, namely copywriting. And that's why it was the first week, because copywriting is so super important for any sales message or any medium, may that be a website, a sales page, an email, a Facebook ad, but even a newspaper ad or anything that you can think of. Good copy is the basis of how people perceive your sales messaging and what they will do. Without that, they won't buy. That's the honest truth. And a lot of business owners or people think that, yeah, nowadays people don't read anymore. I mean, their attention spans are too short anyway. So why should I invest in copywriting? Because they won't read it either way. Well, the truth is that they don't read things that aren't relevant to them. They don't read things that are boring to them, and they don't read things that they just simply don't care about. okay? So if you've done your job properly or your copywriter has done a great job, then your copy has the power to connect with the core of your audience in an emotional way and persuade them in the way that they actually make decisions, because they don't make decisions based on logic, they make it based on emotions. So make sure that you have high converting, good persuasive copy that isn't boring, that is relevant to them, and that speaks to their pains, fears, hopes, and dreams. If you have that, then this alone will be the biggest driver in how well your page actually converts. Okay, hack number four is that you should have clear next steps. And again, I see this all the time. A lot of people overlook this. It's not enough to just give them a call to action button, even if that's super visible. It's not enough. People are afraid to do certain actions, and they're wary of scammers, especially nowadays on the internet. Their default mode is to do nothing, and you have so many objections to contend with when you want them to do something. It's very hard. It's very hard to get people to take an action that you want them to take, because they are all living their lives. They're distracted by various things. If you just give them a simple call to action, like book your free consulting session now, or buy now, or something like that, it's not good enough anymore. They want to know what happens if they click that button. So don't be afraid to spend a few paragraphs explaining that once you click this button, you'll be taken to a checkout form where you can enter your information. Everything is super safe. Your data is private. And then once you submit, then you can expect a welcome email from me within 30 minutes that will include this and this and that. And in case you're wondering, yes, there's a 30-day money-back guarantee, so you don't risk anything. So stuff like that, don't be afraid to use it, because it will massively increase the trust factor of people in you. And in most of the cases, they'll just click through to see whether the thing that you predicted actually came true. So it's a very subtle persuasive tactic, but it definitely works. So make sure to do this. And the final hack that I have for you has to do with branding, because branding and your design language is also important. Now, again, this deserves its own course, and I could spend hours and hours telling you about design elements, although I'm not a designer primarily, but make sure that the marketing messages that you communicate are in tandem with your branding, with your fonts, with your UX, with the colors, with the subtle subconscious messaging that you're putting out there, okay? This has to be consistent, because otherwise people will feel a disconnect. And whenever you give them a chance to feel this disconnect, you drastically increase the chances of them bouncing away, because there's other things to do. There's yet another cat video that they haven't seen yet. And you know, they're just not gonna care about all the hard work that you put into your funnel and sales page and anything else. So make sure that you hire a brand strategist if you're big enough and if you can justify the cost, and make sure that your branding is nice and consistent. Even if it's minimalist, you don't have to overcomplicate this. But eventually, you want to make sure that everything is nice and consistent, and it doesn't provide yet another barrier for people. And it's it communicates that subtle message that you want people to hear without even saying something. So it's a visual, psychological thing, but it's super important. Okay, so the five hacks again for you. One, make sure that you have message matching between the elements of your funnels. Two, make sure that you have a good UX that doesn't create barriers for people and that makes your website and all your marketing channels easy to use. Third, make sure that your copy is high converting and it connects with the pains, fears, hopes, and dreams of your audience. Fourth, make sure that you give people clear next steps, because otherwise they won't know exactly what to do. And remember, their default thing to do is always to do nothing. And finally, make sure that your branding is consistent and it communicates the message that you want people to hear. So go ahead and try to implement at least one of these, and you'll see a nice bump in your results. So thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.